What a weird outfit. What went through your mind? Let me know. Jeez, what is this? What? Okay.
Hey, you.
Sorry, I mean, even though the Enclave benefit is great and I would like to keep them, but I need you. Hi, what's good, survival veterans? Tino here, SOD2. Some Lethal Zone guide. This time, live. Because I want to show you a couple of things. It used to be a cap or something that many people has been manifested into many players' minds that there is a enclave cap of 12. You can actually have way more than that. If you got a trader as a leader, you get a certain quest popping up. Especially if you haven't, like in my case, finished all the playcards. I set up a leader within my first few playcards, but it doesn't matter when you choose a leader, pick a leader. You constantly get something like this. You can see the Enclave benefits, Assault Playcard. You get the Strange Request. There's some, all of a sudden, a new Enclave spawning on your map. Doesn't matter if you do the mission or if you cancel the mission, they stay on your map. So you can see I got 14 Enclave because you can't consider the Bounty Broker. But 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, or 15 actually. You can see the name, the soldiers, exterminators. They used to be, like it says in the small info down below, a group of ex-cons who allied with us. So yeah, they broke out of the prison. And my topic today is how to get soldiers and more useful potential survivors or community members for your team. So you can see, for example, because I don't know why, but military operators or soldiers or military survivors are kind of loved on the community out there, and I know that there are many videos already out there about this topic, but I wanted to give my two cents about it and how I got all those soldiers here. For example, the stranded soldiers here, the remaining soldiers. I already helped them with one mission and they stayed at neutral, but there's the mission like that one that I told you. There's this bug that you can select throughout the missions. It will also provide me the same benefit like them. Assault Playcard or the ex-cons, like here, Assault Playcard. It's not a useful Enclave benefit, but for example, I also got another one like Looters, Psycho Killers, not, but those, for example, the soldiers, stranded soldiers, remaining soldiers, surviving soldiers, there are a bunch of them. And as you can see them, they're all military operators.
Can you maybe clear out some Zeds for us?
Sometimes they have, which is why I'm coming to my next point. If you want to recruit them, just get them up to Allied. Most of these only need 1 to 2 missions, especially those ones, like I said, that come up with this idea that they want to provide you playcard support. You will notice that as soon as they contact you via radio, they call you, hey, we heard you wanted to assault playcards, and then you already know you have to do one mission, but it's a bigger mission. It's not something simple. It's mostly like providing 2 rock six to them or 3 first aid kits. That's at least the way how I got my 2 enclaves. And the Enclave benefit, Playcard Assault, isn't a great one. It's weaker than it sounds, it's at least for Lethal Zone here. But what I'm talking about, in case you want them, sometimes they have or provide, for example, munitions. It's a great one. About 2/3, at least 60, 70, 80%, something like that, that I saw so far of the soldiers usually have discipline as a wit skill already. Specialized. And discipline is, in my opinion, the best. Just my opinion, okay? This could be the Bellwood Sword, or at least the World War I bayonet.
Another
so this
day,
one is an interesting character. So you can see what equipment they have and just recruit them for that, and later on exile them, or instantly exile after you took all their stuff that you want.
There.
Sometimes they're good.
Clear out some Zeds for us?
But the way how you figure out if they're pretty useful, I already did it in my last video. Is if you check their health. This one, for example, isn't bad. He has 134 health. So he must have one of his traits. Must be a health-boosting trait. Something like, maybe not immortal, not unbreakable, because otherwise it would be at 145, 155, something like that. But maybe fights offensively, I think resilient. Or if their stamina is high, they might have just...
How are you?
Just keeps going, exuberant, stuff like that. He has 100 and... 27 stamina, but just because of discipline, which provides 24 stamina when it's maxed out. So I quickly do this mission. Okay, he's for example terrible. He had a penalty on a stamina. Oh, this one's good. I mean, okay, it could also depend due to sewing, because sewing provides additional plus 20 health, but nonetheless, he had 154 health without endurance, so he might have another trait that provides him additional 32, 30 something, 25 max health at least. So yeah, my main topic is simply promote a trader leader before you finish the plague herds, and yeah, you're good. The main thing is you also should consider doing those missions, otherwise they're like this, they will stay at neutral. And just so you can make sure soldiers or remaining soldiers, surviving soldiers, whatever, can also provide you several different very useful enclave benefits like that. Dinner theater, plus 6 morale and 1 food unit per day. It's among the best in my opinion. I mean, yeah, maybe not the as strong as it used to be. The next one, they provided me gun safety club, ammo income, yeah, 1 ammo unit. Hey, it's alright, but yeah, nothing special. What a weird outfit. What went through your mind? Let me know. Jeez, what is this? What? Both 165 health and... Okay.
Hey, you.
Sorry, I mean, even though the enclave benefit is great and I would like to keep them, but I need
so,
you.
We want
yes,
you on our team.
I don't care.
Them?
I need this
not
girl.
So much. Actually, I tell people Gia, to fuck
stay,
up
stay
way
here.
These days.
Grimes, let me check her. That's incredible. Hold on. She got immortal and lived at a high altitude. Jeez. Okay, she's traitor, unfortunately, but would have loved to have a... Finally a builder on this community. Hunter, I mean, you already saw my guide on him. Cornell was later on brought to the community. Okay,
hey.
Well. I just provided them what they needed. I did the...
So, what do we got today? Sure.
You give me
how's
that.
It going? Go away while I'm still letting you.
You and the other remaining soldiers didn't want to get up from neutral to friendly, so we have to do it otherwise,
go
right?
Go away while I'm still letting you walk.
I won't let you walk after that. Not even a wheelchair will be fitting for you.
Straight to hell.
Don't come any closer.
Jesus. Come on, it's BS.
Fire in the hole!
I said it, BS. Get up, girl. Oh, he was already a zombie. A zombification. So, there we go. With their own weapons taken out. That's embarrassing. Well, that was embarrassing too. Well, I just said it. You had some useful stuff. Thanks for that, buddy. So, yeah, if you don't want them, kill them. But not in that matter. It's way too complicated. You just end up killing your own character. Or actually, suggest you. One well-thrown load of cloud grenades kills them all, even on lethal zone. So yeah, that's it. How you get great characters, and also how you can get more than 12 or 13 enclaves on your map. Jesus, I have to switch this ridiculous looking stuff right there. That's better. So yeah, have a great day. Bye. What? This girl never stops in surprising me and getting better and better. Jeez. Pre-packed gear is a hero bonus.